In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to add sound effects to your Arduino project. You'll need an Arduino, a buzzer shield, and you need female to male cables. I'm using this three combined female to female cable and then three separated male to male cables. But it doesn't matter how you connect your shield to the Arduino as long as you can go from female to male. The buzzer shield has three different pins. The first one is the 5V, the center is the data, and the last one is the ground. So I'm going to use this wire to connect to my shield. So now blue is 5V, the white is the data, and the yellow one is the ground. As you can see here in the center, I've connected the female to the male, and then I used the more common colors as black for ground, red for 5V, and green for the signal. So I'm connecting the ground to the black one, the data, the signal to the 12, and the red one to the 5V. So now my speaker shield is connected to the Arduino. So this is the code we're going to use for our buzzer. And we start with defining the buzzer pin, which I've set to pin 12. We set the buzzer pin as an output. And during the loop, we're going to execute the beep function. And that's a function I defined myself over here. It's called a void function since it doesn't return anything. It just creates a tone. So when this function is called, we execute the tone function of the Arduino. We execute this on the buzzer pin, which is pin 12. You use a frequency of 196 Hz and for a duration of 200 milliseconds. If you want to know more about the tone function, you can go to the Arduino website, and there is a reference for the functions built in the Arduino, and one is tone. And here you can read all about how tone works. You can also see that it's not really necessary to add a duration. You can also use it with only the pin and a frequency. There are a couple of other functions which could be used for sound. So they created here pulse in long, but no tone, etc. You can all read that by yourself. I'm now going to upload the code to my Arduino and we'll see what it does. So I've uploaded the sketch, and as you can hear, every 5 seconds you hear the beep, so your sketch is working. So this is the code of our second exercise, which is to create a melody instead of a single tone. The first line already is something new. It's include pitches.h. As you remember in the previous exercises, this was a library. But this is not a library which we can import. This is just a file called pitched.h in our project. You can go to the link below this video to download this file, since you do not want to type all the values in your own pitched.h. If you look into the file, there are a lot of defines. Basically, these are all the notes and their frequency. Instead of crowding this code with hundreds of lines of definitions for certain pitch of a tone, I choose to separate it in pitched.h and include the file over here. So what the compiler does is look into the file and basically paste it here on the position where you add this pitched.a include line. Then we set the variable buzzer pin to 12, which is the buzz pin we're using. And here is the melody. The melody is an array, as you can see by these symbols. And it has multiple notes, like a C4, G3, G3. And this melody defines our song. These notes are defined in this pitches.h. So the easy thing is that you can now define notes by name. The notes have different durations, so I've created another array with several integers. Here you see 4, 8, 8, 4, 4, 4, 4. The idea is that this is a fourth note and this is an eighth note, which takes an eighth of a second and this one a quarter of a second. We tell in the setup that the bus pin is an output, and then in the loop we start playing the melody and wait for 10 seconds and play the melody again. And this is where the magic happens. You iterate over the note length. In our case, there are 8 notes. And this index, the variable I, is increased every time we go through the loop. So in the first iteration it's 0, in the second it's 1, etc. So we're going to calculate the duration of the first note. It's 1000, which is 1 second, divided by the note duration on position I. So if you look over here, this is the note duration. For the first note, I is 0, so it takes the first, the zeroth index, which is 4. So it calculates a quarter note duration, which is 250. Then we call tone, which you remember from the previous exercise. We play a certain frequency, which is melody, and then index I, which is also 0. Melody 0 points out to note C4, which is a frequency here at C4, 262 Hz. It plays the duration which we calculated over here, so 250 milliseconds. In order to distinguish the several notes, we have to create a certain pause. And this pause is 30% above the note duration. So we multiply it by 1.3 to get this extra 30%, and we pause the Arduino for this amount of seconds. Then we stop playing the current note and we go to the second position. So then with I++ we say add 1 to I when the loop is finished, or the iteration is finished. So in the second iteration I is 1. So it goes to the second note duration, which is 8, and to note G3, and starts playing the melody.
So I've uploaded the sketch to my Arduino with our melody, and as you can hear, the melody works. So I remove the signal pin to make him quiet, otherwise it kept repeating every 10 seconds. But now you've created your own melody and you have used a library for these notes. I encourage you to experiment with your own melodies and keep in mind that you need to take care of the durations and the notes. If you have the durations with 8 positions and the notes with 10 positions, it doesn't work. So make sure for every note there is a duration defined. See you in the next episode.